Hello, this is a recording of a live session from Spark 2021. We hope you enjoy it. Good afternoon and welcome to Spark Ignite 2021. We're here in our freelance support session, which is going to be exploring the freelance ecosystem here in Warwick District. I'm going to hand over now to Sarah Brewster, Managing Director of Fresh Seed HR. Over to you, Sarah.
Thanks, Bronwyn. Welcome, everybody. Great to see a virtual room full of so many people. Ordinarily, I'd be standing on stage and bouncing around, but because I can't, and we can't, then I'm going to bounce around in my room and hopefully it brings it to life for you. So a little bit about today's session, and as you can see, it's all about freelancers and the exploring the ecosystem that is here in the district and what will happen, what has been happening over this last year. So, as Bronwyn said, my name's Sarah. I run Fresh Seed. It's an HR agency to the media and creative industry. I've worked in this industry for 20 plus years. In that time, I have worked with, recruited, and managed freelancers, and I'm even married to one. I'm passionate about the talent, energy, and creativity that freelancers provide. The industry, and let's face it, the world. But I'm also passionate about the group of people that that freelancers are and how misunderstood the wider world you are to the wider world. And that has been evident through the work that we have done for the freelancer gap with the LEP this year. And so as we go through this session, we'll give you some more information on that and the work that we've been doing to try and get some more leverage for you in this region. So I'm now going to hand over to the fabulous Amy, who can introduce herself.
Thanks, Sarah. Hi, everybody. It's lovely to be here. And my name is Amy, as Sarah introduced me as. And I am a creative consultant and a freelancer based in Warwick District. I work in the arts and I have a background as a dance artist. So I trained and I worked initially at the beginning of my career as a dance artist in the community. And then I've had a series of jobs, management jobs, mostly in the arts for various funded organisations. And then in lockdown number one, because like we've had a lot of lockdowns, haven't we? In lockdown number one last year, I went freelance and thought, oh my God, as I'm sure many of us have had many, many differing thoughts throughout the pandemic. And I thought, God, what am I going to do? There's no events, there's no performances with a background in dance. Can't deliver anything, can't produce anything. What am I going to do? So I pivoted where I was at and I've built a small freelance portfolio working with other freelance artists, arts organisations, dancers, and yeah, make a lot of stuff happen at the moment. That is in the form of fundraising. So I pivoted and kind of looked at my skills and thought, what is it that I can do now? And as somebody who is relatively new to Warwick District, I moved here back in early 2019. So I've only been here a couple of years. And we'll come on to this, as Sarah said, later into the presentation. But I found myself looking around thinking, how can I meet more people? How can I network, put myself out there, find out what's going on, find out where to access support as a freelancer? And then Sarah and I had a conversation. It came about because my last role was at Motion House, who some of you may know as a local dance company based in Leamington. That was the last role, employed role that I did. And Sarah's daughter was dancing in one of the classes. So when I emailed everybody to say I was leaving, Sarah replied going, "What's happening? Where are you going? We should talk." And then, long story short, here we are. We've carried on talking and we've talked about, you know, from my perspective as a freelancer, what we need, what I need, and I take into account other freelancers that I work with locally as well in terms of their views. Some are here today. Hello. So that's a bit about me. And then I think I'm going to hand back over to you, Sarah, to go into the presentation. Shall we do that, or shall we find out who's here first?
Who's here first? If you want to interact on the chat and introduce yourselves, feel free. And then as you do that, we can continue to talk about the work. How about that? Does that sound good? Right, Amy, do you want to skip on them? And off we go. So as well as introducing yourselves, feel free to use this Menti app, and you can tell us three key things. What we'd like to hear about is, how are you today? How have you felt about the last year? And how do you feel about the year ahead? Hopefully a little bit more positive. So feel free to get to tell us more about yourselves on the chat and get involved with Menti. We'd love to be able to capture some of the feeling in the room today. As you do that, I will give you some background into what this activity has been and what's been going on for you. I'll just leave Amy just to do this for a minute, because I know she's got some technical wizardry to do for a minute. Yeah. So I'm just going to let you.
Yeah, thank you, Sarah. Just before we go on, just the instructions are on the screen. So if you have a smartphone and a camera on that, you can take a photo with that QR code and it should take you through to a new browser and it should pop up. And then a screen with further instructions should also come up. But if that doesn't work on your phone, then open the internet, open the new browser, type in menti.com, menti.com, and then you'll be prompted to give that code. So the code is 8989458, and you should be able to then access this next screen. So I'm just going to give you a little bit of time to do that, because I think there may be a bit of a lag within this session. So I'm going to give you a little bit of time to do that before then Sarah whizzes on with the next part of our talk today. And then there will be some wizardry, some technical wizardry, where we'll go through the next screen. So I'm going to do that now. So bear with me whilst I bring up Menti. Hopefully everybody has scanned the QR or is in Menti right now, entering your feelings, answering the questions that Sarah just mentioned. So if you miss those instructions, you can also access the instructions in the chat. So yes, if you need to, you can just scroll up the chat and have a look. There's already some words coming up, which is really
fab. They look great, don't they?
Yeah, they look fab. It's really interesting. It's really good to get a picture of where everybody's at. So let's keep watching and see all these words as they come in. And then this will form the first part of our consultation, or rather adds to our consultation. So hopefully in the sign up process to this session, you will have seen a link to a consultation, an online consultation that Sarah and I have pulled together. We'll be referring to that throughout this presentation, continuing to refer to it. And if you haven't completed it, we ask you to do so at some point today or in the near future, so that we can really gather your thoughts. It should take you about 10 minutes. And then we'll add this information from this screen right here from Menti, and also anything else that pops up in the chat today in response to Sarah and my provocations and questions for you. So it's still coming in. So keep those words coming in, everybody. Look at those, Sarah. There's a real mixture of words there.
There is tired, I'm reading. Overlooked, I can see, and disheartened. And we'll come to that during this presentation, because we know that those are some of the issues that we've understood as we've gone forward. But there's also some real positives in there, and that's great to see. Perhaps they reflect what we're looking forward to the next year. So as we go forward, I will start to give you a little background into this work and how we've come to do it. So I'd like to say it was all my brainchild, but it isn't. It was part of the LEPS priorities as the pandemic took its grip last year. As this pandemic began to unfold, the LEP recognised that some businesses were greatly affected by it. Obviously, hospitality and leisure was one of those, in retail. But what we also recognised was that freelancers form a lot of that those groups that were affected. And we know that some of the financial support that was given perhaps missed you out. So what we discovered was that we needed to do something about it. And it was through that work with the LEP that I was brought it on board to help lead the freelancer gap work. So I'm just gonna leave Amy to try and take me back to the slide deck, otherwise I'll be waffling on and you'll be wondering what the hell. There is slides that go with this. So one of the things that we recognised in our work across that LEP piece was that you demonstrate yourselves in all manner of different ways. Now, I know that from my work in HR, but what that means is, whilst I might know that, other people who are making strategic decisions about the region don't understand that. And what we needed to do was to do some work to capture that and to capture that freelancer gap. And so what we wanted, Amy, next slide. So what we wanted was to try and get you to be more understood. We wanted to beyond the industry to get that message across that you are the lifeblood of the industry. You are you're not employees, you can't be employed, and we don't want you to be. What we wanted to get that message firmly on the radar is that you exist for good reason. Sometimes, perhaps in a filming and TV way, it's because of the way that teams sort of start and then close on a project basis, and the same with sort of other productions, more creative productions. But equally, across the media sector, we wanted to get you understood in terms of sort of why you matter and how it just how important what energy you bring to this world and creativity. So our ambitions for the work, well, that was to get that recognition, to get you some financial support, and to create reporting to local government and those strategic decision makers that understand you regionally. We wanted to also connect you to a wider ecosystem, and that's a little bit about where we got stuck, I suppose, and that's why we've opened this more widely, and we're asking you to get involved with the consultation and the next steps that we take. We have achieved an awful lot, but in that time, we really recognise that we understand what we know, but we don't understand enough from people like you today on this call. And so we understood that you fell through some of the gaps from a financial perspective. And so our ambitions were to try and connect you to the grants and the activity that's available for, has been available for you after over last year. And we did that via platforms like LinkedIn and the sort of website messaging from local government. But we wanted to do that more widely. We wanted to connect that more widely. And that was our priority as the app for the ambitions. And so we also needed to write reports and capture how you work. And so we also did that. So Amy, next slide, please, lovely. So as I said, we've learned about the financial support that you did or didn't get. And we learned about things like the language that's used in procurement processes that does and doesn't work. And we learned about where IR35 may be impacting you from your corporation tax point of view, or from your own PAYE kind of setups. And we learned that for some of you, there was no support at all. And for some of you, you felt incredibly isolated and struggled. And that's perhaps where those feelings of overwhelmed or overlooked and disheartened may have come from. But we also realised that in this region, there is a huge amount of energy. There is so many people doing so many good things. And so we, another ambition is to try and connect that to you. So what have we've done? Well, so far we have written a report called the Freelancer Gap. And that Freelancer Gap report formed something called the State of the Nation report. That State of the Nation has gone right up to government, senior government level, and has created a dialogue that has begun to help people understand how you operate. We know it's small steps, but these small steps are crucial in getting you that traction you need for the future. So as Amy and I began to talk, we recognised, as Amy said at the beginning in her introduction, that there are moments in our working lives where we wanted some backup ourselves. You know, I started my business as a freelancer, and there have been times, peaks and troughs throughout the last year, as we've all faced, where actually just having a group hug, albeit virtually occasionally, has been really powerful and kept us focused. And that's something that we want to provide for the freelancer community going forward. So when we look at who's got your back and what goes beyond that, we wanted to create an ecosystem for you with connections, spark connections. We know that there are some amazing pockets of work going on. There's incredible work from, you know, Charlie Budd's Creative Cake Storm right through to all the other networking around. There's some incredible recruiters doing great work like Emma at Beyond the Book, and so on and so forth. There's Amy, there's myself, but where do you find that, particularly if you're new to the region? And where do you find that if you're working in silo or isolation? Where do you find opportunities for work? Well, we wanted to create those that aren't always the corporate body, but perhaps something like the Open to Work UK site that Jonathan Smith and David Keelan have launched, which is a very much a local focused group website. But we also wanted to continue to create that platform of collaboration for you, and reaching out to connections that may not necessarily always feel like just sort of work, but potentially a continual professional development or access to financial support with people like Amy, who helps with that kind of grant funding, or to help with just more general training, which is something that we offer and support you with. And we wanted to give you that kind of feeling that you belong to something that's really powerful and really exciting, and that we are never about losing the passion and the creativity that you offer, but about providing a voice when sometimes perhaps you don't want to be that voice. And we also want to help you be ready for the post-COVID world and what that presents and that looks like. So that takes us to the consultation. So we made lots of assumptions during our work last year, not always assumptions based out of just plucking an idea out of the sky, but assumptions based from people we were talking to and people we know. But we wanted to get more from you. We want more information from you, because the more that we get information from you today, the more information we can share with those people who hold the purse strings, and that way we can draw down funds and shape future opportunity programs and connections for you. We want to be able to give you something that is future facing and that really says that you're on the map. And it's important that you are on the map, because when you are on the map, we face the future of Brexit and we face the future of the post-COVID world. And we want you to know that you're not forgotten and ignored in this region. So the more information you give us on that consultation, the more of you that fill it in and take part, the more information we have and the more of a evidence we have to bang the right doors. So please, if you haven't taken part already, do take part. Do find it on the app today, or we've shared it on our LinkedIn. So feel free to find us on LinkedIn and Twitter, and you'll find that information there. After today, I will make sure that I share it again. So on my Twitter and my LinkedIn feed. So if you need to find it there because you didn't fill it in, do feel free. It doesn't close today. It will keep it open for another few days. But so feel free to just give us your feedback. It doesn't take long. It takes about 5 or 10 minutes to fill in. And again, as I said, the more information we get, the more that we can draw something together for you and hopefully create a positive, energized future for you where you're more connected, you've got more opportunity, more work and more fun, hopefully. So I'm now going to hand over to Amy because I've waffled enough and she's going to talk to you.
So now's an opportunity for you to tell us what you're thinking. So we've told you a bit about where this session has come from and the fact that we, Sarah and I, have had conversations around the support that we need and people that we know and our perception, but actually we really want the truth and to hear from you guys out there. And also picking up on the last slide, if there are any freelancers that you know that live in the district that haven't been able to make it today or don't know about this or don't know about a Spark or the District Council arts team and just, you know, we're a bit out of the loop, please do share with us or share the consultation with them or signpost to a chat with Sarah or I, because we'd be more than happy to have a conversation with any individuals as a follow-up. So questions for you then are, if you were to think about your position right now as a freelancer, as an artist or a creative, what would be the single most helpful thing for you right now to do your best work? So one thing particularly that you might need, or a type of support, or anything. Be that. It's quite a broad question, so think quite broadly about that. And then the second question is, would you be interested in taking part in a freelancers award or recognition event? Now, we don't know what that might look like or the format of that, and obviously everything's still COVID pending. And if so, if that is of interest, any particular categories that you might suggest, is that of interest to you? Do you think that would benefit you and also the wider district? So please tell us what you think about that. And then finally, this is all about creating solutions and opportunities, and the consultation will hopefully be a body of evidence that can be shared with the LEP and other funders and other strategic bodies to put together something in the future. And I say something, that something could be training, it could be webinars, it could be further signposting, it could be anything that you guys come up with, basically. And so what are those solutions to the current problems that we're facing? And what are the opportunities for a creative post-pandemic future here in Warwick District? It's an opportunity to free think. Have you got any ideas? And please share them with us. Pop them in the chat, please feel free to share equally. And if you're not comfortable putting that in the chat, then you can always contact us separately, as I said earlier, and or put it into the consultation, because the consultation is confidential. So I think I've covered everything there, Sarah, is that right? In terms of
brilliantly, fantastic.
And yeah, I think we'd like to have a look at the chat now. How do we look at the chat? So just open the chat then.
I'm seeing some really interesting comments, Amy, and things that we've actually already said about connecting, or we feel about connecting work to people more widely than just sort of their pockets of clients that they already use. That's a really interesting one. And also kind of connecting people together. There's some really interesting people on today's talk. A nice idea about creating a directory of freelancers. The issue is keeping that continually administrated and who helps us with that. But perhaps it's a self-serving thing. Certainly, I think that's one of the ambitions of Open to Work. The Open to Work website, I should say. But perhaps there's another way to do that. Being able to exchange creative spaces, yeah, so that's an interesting one. Dance needs to be a space. That's Amy, over to you, Amy. That's a great one for you.
I am still catching up, I must admit. I'm still scrolling through. I'm having a look here. Yeah, looking at the range of people who are here, which is really exciting, a real cross-section of different backgrounds and art forms and creative mediums, which is fab. It's really about a real diverse range of voices that are represented in the consultation, which is fab. So I'm coming down, I'm scrolling. Danny says, hi Danny, find it useful to find more ideal / niche clients, confidently relaying the value of what I can do for clients, not have that value financially compromised. So, and develop scripts to deal with objections or rejections from clients. Okay, that's interesting. Definitely something to be looked at, I think. And there's something in there around perhaps a little bit of resilience in how rejections and objections are handled, potentially. Yeah. Nicola's saying the most helpful thing would be connections to new clients and a recommendation network / system. Ooh.
Yeah, that's an interesting, that's a really good one, isn't it? A bit like a glass door, but without allowing bad stuff. Yeah. No bad stuff, only good stuff. I wonder if the Open to Work UK site has the functionality to do that. That might be a really good thing to feed back to them, is to allow them to have that. And I think there's a common thread here about connecting people to work and that kind of directory idea of sort of allowing agencies to access and businesses to access that connection. I think it goes more widely than just the sector. It goes right out to wide industry to say, you know, these are the talents and these are the great people that are working in this region, and they're talent for a good reason. You don't want to employ these people, because if you employ these people, you kill the talent. These people are freelancers for good reason. Shall I hammer that home a bit more? If I had a mic in my hand now, I wouldn't be passing it back to Amy. Let's just put it that way. I'd be standing, jumping up and down on the stage. So it's probably quite a good job that I don't.
There's a couple more. I'm just going to move on to a couple more. We've still got plenty of time. So please type away, everybody. And think, you know, I encourage you to think really broadly about anything and everything, any challenges or opportunities that you think we could look at. So Hannah is saying, advice on the practicalities of setting up your business infrastructure would be helpful. Now, Hannah, I could have a little bit of info really quick just there. Is Warwickshire Carver offer a free service locally. Now, that is with a slant on voluntary and community organisation and company infrastructures. The LEP may be able to help on business infrastructure particularly as well. So, and Sarah. So
that's what that's some of the work that I do. So I can help that with that. I think there's some really interesting ones. I think what would be really good to for you to think about as well is, you may not feel that something that has challenged you over this last year is something that you can access through the region and the regional kind of work. But that's stuff that we want to capture today and on the consultation. If you think that, you know, your resilience has been affected, that you just fed up, you know you found this year particularly tough, share that in any way you can, because those are the things that we're trying to seek to support you on as well. Is we recognize that this isn't just about work. This is about, you know, paying bills and getting, you know, mortgage and homes, you know, the challenges of homeschooling this year and all those things. And perhaps, you know, shape that kind of future of work piece and how we operate and understand people in the work world. And obviously that work world is totally varied. So if you think that there's something that you're not, you know, you has impacted you, but you perhaps didn't relate it to work, but it is work, you know, has impacted your work and your ability to do work, then feel free to share that too.
A few people are saying, Sarah, about a place for freelancers to meet or chat or network. Now, you and I talked about that, didn't we? I feel like a conversation before Christmas now around where that might be. And is that an online thing or is that a face-to-face thing or is that both? We don't know the answer to that. Is that something that is of interest to people? Would you come to that if that was an event? And if that was an event live, where should that be? And what does that look like? And if it's not, and if it's a virtual sort of format or structure like a Facebook group or a LinkedIn group, you know, how accessible is that to you guys out there? Because, you know, not everybody's on LinkedIn. Many artists, and that's my specialism in the arts industry, and looking at particularly the subsidized art sector, so the funded sector through Arts Council and other funders. Many artists aren't on LinkedIn, but many more creatives from the wider creative and cultural media industries are on LinkedIn and use it very, very effectively. So yeah, I think, what is it? Is it either of those or has somebody else got another idea? And there's a few people saying about a creative space. So there's a couple of performers, a couple of dance artists in here. Hi. Around spaces for coming together, rehearsals, making work, community engagement. That's what Sheila's saying. Need a creative space that caters or appeals to performance artists to enable community engagement for communities who aren't usually able to access creative activities easily.
I think that's interesting. That I think is part of the like creative quarter plans, but perhaps that's too far away for you to find that kind of accessible now. So I wonder whether it's about the spaces that are available, being able to collaborate and share that space out, and finding ways to sort of safeguard that space, but use that space successfully, and recognizing that it exists, I think is really good. There are some other spaces to connect. So there are things like Mill Street in the neighborhood and Meet by the Park, but perhaps they are not for performers, and perhaps that's a really good piece for anyone who is opening and creating these spaces to remember and to think about going forward is and perhaps it's something that we can feed back in terms of getting kind of the people that within that LEP that know what spaces are available to get people to talk to each other and co-collaborate over that sort of thing. So that's really what we're trying to get, and perhaps we get this through sharing on Facebook groups or LinkedIn groups, as you were saying, Amy.
That's interesting. I think it will be certainly interesting to see where the cultural quarter plans go, and also thinking about whether any of the other infrastructure, thinking about a dance company, you know, Motion House or local, whether there could be more collaborative or open opportunities in sharing their space, and or any other performance spaces. You know, as the Loft and Heartbreak have got a space in the current creative quarter as it currently is before any of the new developments take place, or as you say, do the LEP know any businesses or empty units or, buildings that could be repurposed? That's a big piece of work, but is that something of interest or that could be done? Stefania was saying in the chat just then about both virtual and physical spaces to connect would be nice. Great. And on that note, the Spark team is saying that the app is live for a year, so you can continue, there's a bit of a plug there for Spark, to use the Hoover app in terms of people being on there and chatting and networking through that. So that is already an opportunity that's currently live. But is there anything else? You know, what is the right mechanism? What's the most accessible way for freelancers to connect locally And how do we do that? How do we encourage more people and greater diversity and representation of freelancers from different backgrounds, for instance, to engage with us and to talk to us about what their needs are? Does anyone get any ideas about that particularly? That would be really welcome. We'd love to hear more about that. And whilst we're doing that, I'm going to flick on to the next slide, actually, which is might prompt your thinking around the ecosystem. I'm going to go back onto that in a sec. So this is a bit of a visual about an ecosystem. Now, this is what Sarah and I, this is what came out of our brains. This is by no means a complete ecosystem. You know, it's unique to you and everybody's ecosystem looks and feels very different. And certainly when we were thinking about what's in an ecosystem for a creative freelancer, there's lots of different elements to it, and some may be more important than others, and it will flex and change and ebb and flow as we go through life. And obviously, according to lockdown and all the challenges that that's brought with homeschooling and so on and so forth. So looking at this, the things that might already, what is already in your ecosystem, you know, are you, and some of this is about feelings, you know, it's okay not to be okay. And do you know where to go if you're not feeling 100% in terms of health and well-being? But do you need to find work, and how and where do you find work? Do you go to recruiters? Are there newsletters? Where are you looking for those jobs and service? Talked a lot earlier about the Open to Work website. But there's many more other places where you could find jobs that are being advertised and promoted. Who's in your network, and what resources can you draw on to help you along in your freelance career? Do you need money? Do you need grants to make more things happen, to enable more of your work to take place? Where is that funding? How do you get hold of that funding? There are some questions there. Might you need some training or CPD? And not just looking at where the funding is and how to write funding applications, because that's a whole minefield in itself, and that's currently what I'm doing for many artists. But you know, other funding, you know, do you need equipment to make your stuff happen? Could you find money for that, for instance? Or do you need new tech? Or do you need to talk to somebody? There was a couple of people earlier in the chat that were talking about mentoring. And as somebody who's got a mentor and also a coach, so I've also got a positive psychology and business coach, and the two of them together, this is my personal opinion, it's so beneficial to have both, because my mentor is pretty much a creative and what I would class as an artistic mentor, a person who kind of keeps me energized and keeps me excited and buoyed, if you like, and excited about the future and forward thinking. And my coach very much kind of goes, okay, so let's sort through all of that, let's sort through all of the feelings, and she basically keeps me on the straight and narrow, she keeps me on the track, and it's a check back in moment. And I think without either of those two in my ecosystem, I certainly as a new-ish freelancer, but having worked with freelancers my entire career, it's so, so valuable. And, you know, I really know that that has helped me through this pandemic.
I'd echo that. I would echo that. I've got a mentor, and I would echo that that's been really powerful. So is that something that we can provide as a service to freelancers? The other thing that I think in the ecosystem that you can be aware of is sort of, can we provide you support for understanding the language of procurement? So, you know, find it in CW, it's a great site, but and it has some great work on it, but perhaps there's not a connection there for you and you don't feel it, but actually it's understanding how to operate it in order to find that work, because the work is there. And also in the ecosystem, there is incredible recruiters. I've mentioned Emma Beyond the Book, but there are some others, and they provide you with work. And actually, that's great. Not only do they do that, but they can navigate the things like the IR35 in and out of that sort of stuff, and they can help you make sure that you know you're safe and protected from sort of the unscrupulous who don't do their proper checks in that way. So I think that it's really important to recognise that they're there to support you. And also, you know, they make sure that all the legal bits of paperwork are done behind the scenes. And sometimes that happens, particularly on a longer term contract, if that's the way that you operate. But also, you know, I have to say this isn't our idea. It is Emma from Beyond the Books' idea, but the idea of an award ceremony, I think after this year, don't we all need a bit of something to say, well done, we've achieved something, and something that positively celebrates the cross-section of talent in this particular area. So I think, you know, looking at your ecosystem, there is an awful lot that we can provide you and pull together. So we want to know, what platforms do you want to hear about that on? So our next steps, Amy. Mm-hmm. So our next steps are to compile all of the information that we've got on the chat and Menti and from the consultation and to bring it together. So after today, our ask to you is to take away this information and share it. Tell everyone who's a freelancer in this creative sector across this part of the world. We're enormously proud of what we've achieved. We are probably one of the biggest regions for creativity because of things like the games sector, because of things like what came out of the automotive industry and the marketing and PR that came out of that industry, and also all of the craft and the talent. Art by the Park is just this most phenomenal showcase of that talent. So please share this more widely and get as much traction, because as we've already said, the traction that we get from you means that we can make something impactful and lasting. We don't want this to just be a flash in the pan thing. We want this to be something that lasts regionally and really delivers for strategically to those people who don't understand you. We can educate them, but more widely, it celebrates what you do and you do so well. We really want to offer you something that supports you to go forward. So, as I said, share, but also feedback to us. Keep talking to us, keep interacting with us, and help us develop a program of activity that offers you training, that offers you that resilience, offers you connections to people, that offers you connections to work, to wider networks, to support, to just, you know, a laugh when you need it, and a group hug when it's a bad day. You know, all those times when you put the client, call down to a client and think they just did not understand what I just said, and yet we're still in this vicious circle. You know, how can we help you pull those sorts of support together? So tell us. So share that, and we will look to developing something from that information that you give us. So I know we're asking quite a lot of you at the moment, but I think that's the most important message to give out, is that you've got an opportunity to tell us, and that from that opportunity we can develop something for you. So I think on that note, we can show you the resources that are available.
There we go.
I don't know whether any of you are aware of this. There are some, I've forgotten to mention the books. I shouldn't. How could I forget to mention someone like Alison, who's always in my working world? But there's some great books. Alison and Sarah have both written some brilliant books about freelancers and surviving that world, and looking at how, you know, you constantly reinvent yourselves, and how you manage some of those kind of business issues of sort of scaling up or not. So. I've got on there some of the local authorities where you can find the grants and all that financial information. Coventry have got some great grants for freelancers, and Warwick District have had over this last year, and I think still have. So it's definitely worth looking at. Warwick County Council has also got an EAP, so an employees assistance programme. So that means that if you are struggling with any of your kind of mental well-being issues or physical well-being issues, there may well be support for you. I'm sure some of you know that the networks, and certainly one of the most powerful creative one is the Creative Cakes drawn by the fabulous Charlie Budd, but I'm sure there are others. Amy has mentioned her coach, but there are other coaches, and there are loads more other coaches. We've just put a few names on here that we know, but there are loads of others. Obviously, there's membership to IPSI, but there's also the Creative Federation memberships and the Arts Councils and all of those things, as we know. But we want to focus it on what's here, not more nationally, but what's here. So So hopefully this information here will give you some of the resources that we perhaps haven't already. And I'm conscious that that means that we've sort of come to the end of what we were saying. So perhaps we can go back to that mentee thing and summarize some of those pretty pictures, do you think? Those words that give us some optimism.
Yeah, we certainly can. Bear with me.
This is where I go off script and Amy goes, what? At me. But look.
Here we go.
Went with some positivity.
Yeah. I wanted to add as well in terms of, the outcomes of the consultation being for local freelancers, but we're also keen for it to be with local freelancers and not for anyone out there who is doing their own thing to feel like this might be done to you, and that we want to bring you with us on this journey. And I speak for myself as a freelancer, and so I don't want to advocate for anybody else and kind of make any assumptions. So it would be great that, you know, if you have ideas that you might want to contribute, or you have an offer potentially around this ecosystem that we've talked about, and that you could offer training, for instance, or share in a webinar, or be prepared to host a networking session. If you're up for that, also tell us that, because we want to include be with you. So if you have something to offer you think that would be of benefit to other freelancers locally in Warwick, then please tell us that as well. Really would be really excited to know what you could offer. So Sarah, I feel like, has everybody had a go at the mentee? And if you haven't, have a go and put some words in there.
It looks good. I think this probably represents what we think is, don't you? I think this kind of gives us, and it's nice to see it in words. I like to see it like this. I'm visual. I don't like colours and words and pictures like this. It looks good. I think it summarises pretty much everything. Frustrated is an interesting one. And fearful. Yeah, there's some interesting sentiments here. I think pretty much are summed up by things like forgotten, limited, and those other actions that have been going on this year. I think it's been a tough year for everyone. Every walk of life, freelancer or not, but this pretty much sums up the feeling, doesn't it? So hopefully we can give you something hopeful and positive and happy to take away from today, that you are being understood and there is work in the region for you. So I'm conscious we've gone a little through it really quickly. That's probably because I whittled on too quickly at the beginning.
I'm going to go back to the resource slide in case people didn't get an opportunity to have a look at that. So we're back on the resources in case there's anything on there that you wanted to make a note of. And we will put these in the Hoover app so that, there are opportunities to follow up. And Sarah, did you say they're going on your website, or did I just create a piece of work for you then?
They will. It's fine. You can create. It's fine. It's good. It's no problem.
Yeah. And they'll also be up on the Fresh Seed website. And then there's a website there as well. But, there's lots of resources out there. And this is also, this is just a small picture that, earlier Carol put that the arts team have a newsletter. They've also got a Facebook group. So if you are an artist and you want to engage and find out what else is happening locally in the district, that's a really good place to have a look on Facebook and signing up to their newsletter. And there's, I'm sure somebody will post a link in the chat to how to do that if that's not already been done. Has anything been missed here, Sarah? I don't think so, from what we wanted to get out today, other than the final ask being, please, if you haven't already, complete the consultation and do feel free to follow up with us and to connect with us on Twitter or on LinkedIn or on Facebook. And to chat to us about where you're at and anything else that you would like support with.
Yeah, definitely. I think we've got everything on this. I'm sure I'll wake up in the middle of the night and go, oh, I didn't put that on it. But we all know that.
Cool, brilliant. Well, I think we're there. Thank you everybody for coming today.
Thank you. It was great to share such positivity.